I installed the rail on the bottom of the pressure box, and I have a wood block back here to keep the slider from going off the end of the rail. And I have to maintain this clearance in here because the base pipes will be underneath the pressure box. And I use T-nuts in here. This rail is approximately 6 inches long, and it sticks out about 3 1/8. I made this piece that holds the truck or the slider. Then there's this piece. It's got these little forks on the end of it that sits on here. And there'll be one screw holding that to the pressure box. And its job is to catch that slider before this can come off the rail. And it just hits on that. And this also keeps any dust in that from accumulating down in there. But the inside of the argon stays pretty clean normally. With the conductor in place, this is moving out 3 3/8 inches, which is actually just a little more than I need. I only need that to come out this far. I want this to be flush with the edge of the case. And when this comes back, I need to put a little more of a bumper on here. I want this to be just clear of the reservoir. Just in case you forget and you start operating this and this is going up and down, you don't want anything to damage the leather. And when this goes all the way back in, the range of travel on this hand is probably going to be about like that. So when it stops, it will still be inside the front of the argon. This is the front from my first argon. I just put it on here temporarily to see how this guy looks when he comes out. And this will be either flush with the front or the back of this facing. I thought this might be a little bit too springy. That's pretty rigid. And this is all made out of 1/4-inch Baltic birch. Whether you have watched a video before or not, no harm in watching it again. You may have missed something, and it will help support this channel. Thank you for watching. Please tell your friends about my channel. I appreciate it.